Hi everyone! I recently went on a one-night, 2-day weekend getaway to San Diego, and these are the skincare and makeup products that I brought along with me. This is actually the Tory Burch and Target lunch bag, but I use it to store my skincares, and they all fit perfectly in there. When I travel, I usually prefer to travel light, so if it's only for a day or two, I don't usually bring my nighttime skincare to avoid too many bottles and too heavy. So what I'm sharing here is pretty much my daytime routine. So within 10 minutes after I shower, I apply this to my body. This is actually hand and feet lotion, but because I want to travel light, I didn't bring my body lotion and I use this. It's pretty rich, so it's good enough for like a light moisturizing. And it has paraben-free and cruelty-free. It's made in the US and I actually quite like it. This is my first tube. Next, I apply the Dove Original Clean Invisible Solid Deodorant. After a long period of time using this, I noticed the skin under my arm are smoother, and I like that it doesn't stain the clothing. Please use deodorant, especially in the summer. I think everyone has to, unless you are the very few lucky one who do not need deodorant at all. Then I guess good for you. I usually wash my face when I'm taking a shower or after I brush my teeth. In the daytime, I like to use this Naruko Rose Foaming Wash. I have gone through many tubes already and I love the rose line from Naruko. This is very gentle and it doesn't dry your skin at all. I love this rose smell as well and I really recommend this. Next, I use this AMPM Vitamin C Whitening Lotion. This is from Naruko as well. This does not whiten your skin, but it does even out your skin tone and brighten your complexion. I actually love this product a lot, but unfortunately, it has been discontinued and I am running out of it. This is my only bottle, so I need to find something else to replace this pretty soon. Next up is this eye cream from France. It's called Delay. I don't think I'm pronouncing it right in French. Premier Cure La Crème U, the eye cream. This is a very rich eye cream and it's really, really good. I really recommend this as a nighttime eye cream or if you are in a dry environment and have dry skin. Otherwise, if you have oily skin, I do not recommend this as a daytime cream, especially if you're wearing eye makeup because it's probably gonna smudge or melt your eye makeup during the day. A little goes a long way and this is really good. And then I apply this Raw Drop Tears Whitening Serum from Naruko also. I'm finishing this bottle and this has vitamin C as well, so it brightens and tones your skin. I don't really see much of a result on me, so I'm probably not going to repurchase this until maybe later on if they improve the formula and I want to try it again. But for now, I'm not going to repurchase this and I'm looking for a new serum to replace this. So I wait at least 30 seconds to a minute after I apply my serum to let it absorb to my skin properly. Then I apply my moisturizer, which is this Narcissus DNA Repairing Cream by Naruko. This is pretty much my go-to moisturizer over the years, and I have gone through many, many, many bottles of it. Even after I try other brands, I still come back to this. I do recommend people who are trying out Naruko and products for the first time, you don't know what to choose, check out this Narcissus line and I think you'll like it. It's pretty much user friendly for any skin type, I think. And you can use this as a day cream or a night cream as well. This is the newer packaging with the little scoop in the inside, like an ice cream scoop, that you can scoop the lotion instead of using your fingers, so it's more hygienic. So I really like this product a lot. If I'm not outdoor, I'll skip this part. This is an eye cream with SPF 28 from Lancome. I prefer my Shiseido one because it is more moisturizing and has thinner texture. This Lancome one lifts my under eye with some, you know, the dry crisp in the middle of the day, and I really, really don't like that. So I'm probably not gonna repurchase this one. If you have watched my December haul, you know that this is my Holy Grail Daily Sunblock Lotion by Misha. It has SPF 45, PA++++. It is oil-free and paraben-free. I really like this a lot. I usually apply on my face and neck and sometimes my arm as well. This is the white packaging, which is the old version. The pink packaging that you see in the December haul is their new version that just came out a few months ago. And I can't wait to try that one, but I still have the white one to finish up. I really like this very much and I really recommend this. I have gone through many tubes over the years. If I know I'm going to be outdoor on a very sunny day, I apply a second layer of sunscreen, and this is from Obagi. It has SPF 50, PA++++. It is also my holy grail. I am a fan of Obagi skincare as well. I have used the line during my early college years. This one has paraben-free, I believe, and it is fragrance-free, so it's suitable for all skin type. It is matte finish, so I don't have to worry about the white overcast as well. I usually apply this on my cheeks and my nose. Again, I don't use this on a daily basis. This is only when I need to be outdoor under a very sunny day. Final step to my skincare if I'm going to be outdoor is this Neutrogena SPF 70 sunscreen lotion. I usually apply this on my arm and my legs only because it does leave that white overcast, so I don't want it to be on my face. This is waterproof and sweatproof, and I have been using this for many years as well. I also brought with me a facial sheet mask by Silwai Sha. On a short trip, I usually end up not using it, but on a longer trip or after an airplane ride, this is very good as an instant pick-me-up to restore the moisture on my skin. However, this does have paraben. Unfortunately, it's hard to find a sheet mask without paraben in it. I also brought my own cotton bud. Apart from using it to clean my ears, it is also good for applying or removing eye makeup if I don't want to bring my any makeup tools. Oh, and I forgot to take pictures of my toothbrush and toothpaste as well. So that's all the skincare that I brought with me. I usually put a towel in the skincare bag just in case anything spills. The towel will absorb the liquid and will not make a mess in the bag. And here is an overview of all the skincare products that I mentioned and I brought to the short trip. Oh, that green two little ones are Go Smile freshman touch-ups. I guess I forgot to take individual photo for that. It polishes your teeth, freshens your breath, and prevents stains on your teeth. It's like a to-go thing that you put on your purse. So on to makeup. When I travel and I'm not meeting people or not going party, I don't bring a lot of makeup. It's everything's minimum. This makeup pouch is from Daiso. It has a little mirror on it. And here is an overview of what I brought. You'll be surprised, only a few pieces. So let's get started. So after my daily skincare routine, the first thing for my makeup routine is to apply lip balms to the lips to moisturize and soften them before applying lipstick later on. For the past 4 to 5 years, I have not been using foundation much. I usually use BB cream. This signature BB cream by Misha is one of their newer products last year. I usually only apply a very thin layer on my face, so just a little goes a long way, and just kind of dab it around your skin to even it out. I like that it has SPF 43, PA++++, and it's not drying to my skin at all. Then apply my lipstick. This is by Lancome. It's Rouge in Love number 156. It is also in my December haul video. I like it because it's very pigmented, long-lasting, moisturizing, and it's very lightweight on the lips. Then I'll use a compact powder to set my BB cream. Please wait until your BB cream is semi-dry before you do this step. Otherwise, you will leave patches of powder on your face, and that's not pretty. When you apply the powder with a sponge, please use the dab and blend motion instead of rubbing it into your face. This is One of my favorite compact powder is by Too Faced. It has SPF 15 and has very good coverage. I really love this one. This is in perfect nude. This Beauty Rush Choppy Eye Stick is by Victoria's Secret. If I don't want to bring a lot of eye makeup, especially on a short trip, this is a very versatile piece. I can just draw a line for a very thick eyeliner, or blend it with my finger as an eyeshadow, or use it as an eyebrow pencil by dabbing really lightly along the eyebrow and then blend it with a cotton bud. And there I have it, a very simple eye makeup is done. This eyelash curler is by Shimura, collaborated with Karl Lagerfeld. I'm a huge fan of Karl Lagerfeld. You don't have to curl your lashes, but it helps to brighten and open up your eyes so you don't look as tired. So here's an overview of the very few makeup products that I brought along with me. Please remember that skincare is a lot more important than makeup. So invest in good skincare for your skin type, and you don't need a lot of makeup to make you look good. That's all for my little video today. Hope you enjoy watching. Take care, be kind, and I'll see you in my next video. Bye!